Hi everyone, this is Marianne from Revealing Light, Tarot Astrology and Spirituality. Thank you for tuning in to my readings. Thank you very much for your comments and support of my travel vlogging. I hope I'm in the process of lining up a visit to one of Australia's most haunted houses. We'll get a feel for the history around that area. So fingers crossed I can line that up and we'll be doing some more travel vlogging. Because as you know, I love to travel. Okay, so let's just quickly look at the astrology before we move into the cards. So the moon, it's the 17th of March here in Australia, the morning of, I guess, around 10 a.m. in the morning. And the moon is in Virgo here. And if you're in the Northern Hemisphere, moving from Leo to Virgo. And of course, we have our full moon in Virgo coming up over on Friday or over the weekend, toward the end of the week, depending on where you are in the world. It gets confusing with the time zones. And then after the full moon in Virgo, we get a new moon in Libra. So again, the full moons are all about things coming to a culmination, and the new moon is when we set our goals and our dreams for the coming cycle, lunar cycle. Today in Australia, and this is what you're heading into, we do have a little bit of relief. The sun is sextiling Pluto. Again, you know, a sextile trines, that's when the energy is harmoniously flowing. The squares are when there is a conflict. And the oppositions are when you get two opposite forces pulling at one another, and the conjunctions are when you get a blending of energies, for those that are learning a little bit more about astrology. So over the last week, we've had a huge amount of conjunctions. So major planets, major energies, sun, moon, all conjuncting with these planets, the blending of energies. We know something huge is happening in our globally, and something tragic is happening. We know that there is an invasion. We know that Vladimir Putin's era is coming to an end. I mean, he will be charged with war crimes. The International Court of Justice has come out and said that he's invaded Ukraine illegally. And also come out and said there is no substance at all to any of the charges that Russia is leveling at Ukraine. So the truth is there. It's interesting to see how that is playing out in the various countries. Zelensky, the president of Ukraine, has addressed most parliaments around the world, major parliaments, and Congress has addressed Congress. Three out of four Americans support a no-fly zone over Ukraine. From a starting point in February of one in four not wanting any part of a war with Russia and Ukraine. So, you know, the feelings are running high, the feelings of support for Ukraine, and why wouldn't they when we see this, the propaganda war waged by the Hitler-like Putin, and also the tragedy that is unfolding in Ukraine while we watch it. So there's an $8 billion package just been approved to go to Ukraine from the US. Massive amounts of monetary assistance, but they need help, with weapons, and B, to counteract anything that Russia might throw at them in the air, by the air. And so it might be time now to see that they get the jets that they want, and in some way to do that. In the longer term, we know that the sanctions are biting. Russians, Putin has come out and suggested he will back off if Ukraine becomes neutral and demilitarizes to a certain extent. He's also addressed his people and said the West, the wicked West, are causing all of this unemployment now, and to a certain extent, people feeling the effects of those sanctions. So again, he wages his propaganda war. We know that. We know he lies. And it puts all of the big lie that occurred in America into context, doesn't it? Because the invasion of Ukraine has been a big wake-up call if we don't rein in the liars. Okay, and the aggressors and those that would seek to overturn democratic systems. So back to the astrology. And yes, anyone that doesn't like this fight for justice and truth on this channel can. Okay, so enough said. Sun is conjunct Neptune, so we are still in the stages of forming something. Sun sextiling Pluto, so it's like what needs to come up will come up. The moon is opposite Mercury. So again, we see propaganda, truth being manipulated. The four ex-president has now come out after s congratulating Putin on the invasion of Ukraine as being smart and savvy. He's now come out and said, oh, he's backtracked. So, we get this, the moon will bring up what needs to be brought up, and that is the truth. Regardless, we get to see through the lies, see through the propaganda, and particularly at this time. The moon is trining Uranus, so the change that we're seeing, Uranus being the planet of this dynamic change, the moon is now we're moving into a new moon in Libra, so we're seeing the details, and then we're seeing justice playing out. And we have Mercury sextiling Uranus at the same time, so we're seeing the impact of through the footage, through the stories, through the speeches of the invasion of Ukraine and the war criminal that Putin is. Now Venus is squaring Uranus. Venus being the Earth, Uranus being that push, that explosive push for change. So in a way, there is conflict about the speed of what is occurring, and aside from the tragedy that is Ukraine, we also see some of those beautiful historic heritage buildings, cities, suffering so much destruction, along with the killing of civilians. Brave people in Russia are standing up. Brave people are standing up. Let's not forget them. Let's not forget the resolve of our Western leaders, those that are taking away the oligarchs' yachts and property and freezing funds. Let's not forget them either. All right, let's get started with the reading. First of all, I just want to do some medicine wheel cards. So tis, it's been quick and it's been tragic, the change. But I do feel we've been building up to this. We are learning the meaning of freedom in all its guises, in all of its glory. We are learning that or relearning that. And, I keep saying this is the end of the patriarchy. This whole invasion of Ukraine is about taking away someone's freedom to decide. And in my paper, I did talk about another variant coming of COVID. We now have a variant of Omicron taking hold. We're not going back to lockdowns. People will be free to choose. Simply because the Omicron strain is not as deadly as Delta, or not as, I guess deadly as Delta. We are also seeing a lot of hypocrisy. Mask mandates don't exist in most places now, yet people are getting abused for choosing to wear masks by the people who were agitating that their freedoms were taken away. None, I mean, you can rem you recall Ron DeSantis abusing young kids for wearing masks. The trucking convoy. There are no federal government mandates in the US on truckers yet. Yet they go round and round and round. Okay. It, you know, when you can see the circus, you know that progress is being made. And we are waking up. We are waking up. All right. Let's have a look at our cards here, our medicine cards for some overarching messages, please, for the collective. What are the overarching messages for the collective? Okay, so, All right, so there's something around the breath or breathing, needing to take more in more air. I don't know what that's about. It's just an image that came to me. Like people, okay, it's like oxygen. All right, so let's keep going. Also, I want to say I don't read on other readers' predictions. I stay true to my own clairvoyancy and intuition, and I don't blend or merge with anyone else's predictions, and that's the decision that I take. So when you ask, can I read on this or read on that? I just don't do that. Most questions I answer anyway, or most questions I've covered. So if you're new to my videos, scroll back and have a look. I did see it was possible that Putin may or had aircraft ready to go, almost like an isolated something around a missile that wasn't or that wasn't quite nuclear, and we had him then looking at thermobaric bombs. There is good evidence out there he's used that. I haven't addressed more recently the question of nuclear. I didn't think he would use nuclear in a large scale attack, but I cannot rule out a smaller, more isolated nuclear attack. The real worry for me is that he will use chemical warfare. And the fact, anyway, I haven't pulled cards on that either, mate. If we've got time, we'll get to it. All right, let's get a move on. Overarching messages for the collective. Medicine shield, protection. I do feel that at this time of unease and flux in the energy, in the collective energy, we do need to protect ourselves. We also need to understand that I think we need to be doing more in Ukraine. The medicine wheel continuation. So that tells us that in a way, I do feel, if you've noticed in my last video, I mentioned the skies. I keep seeing this huge open sky. It's like the universe is closer in some way. I do feel we are being protected at this time. And it's like the circle. I can just see the unity, the support here acting as a protection. So we do need to protect ourselves no matter what your situation is. If you're feeling threatened or vulnerable, take the steps. It's your right to take those steps. Do what you need to do. Follow down what you need to follow down, even though it might be difficult. But I do see continuation here, like a preservation. And we have here altar honoring. Yeah, part of, I love the spiral energy here too. It's sort of a little bit like the Three of Pentacles, honoring the unity, honoring strength in unity, honoring the sacrifices and the bravery that we've seen so much of. And that's including surrendering Russian troops who say, we didn't want to do this. The bravery of the Russian protesters, the bravery of the Ukrainians. I mean, I'm just so moved, like you. And I just want more to be done. I want somehow, if the world can't come together to stop the deaths, his deliberately terrorizing terrorist deaths of Ukrainian children, what can we do? You know, what can we do? So, or manage the threats of a dictator hell-bent on threatening the world with nuclear weaponry. Please don't forget that Trump withdrew America out of a nuclear treaty. So we have buried in the earth transference. There's something around the breath here, and something around things coming to the surface. I'll dig down the upper world, the future. So really, this is back to my big skies. I have the feeling of ascension in many, many, many ways. Whether it's an expose of the hypocrisy, whether it's an expose of the lies, whether it's an expose of what freedom really does mean, and you understand that very gravely when you see what happens when freedom is taken or tried to be taken away in such an aggressive, blood, thirsty, murderous way. So, there are no two sides to this, by the way. If anyone wants to pop up and defend Putin, you'll just get banned from this channel. There are no two sides to this. When a country is invaded and people are being killed, massacred, you don't get to stick up for the invader and the murderer. There are no two sides. So if you're on that side of the coin, you're as bad as what he is, because you're sanctioning war crimes. Journey, imagination. That's interesting. That is interesting. Imagination. Jupiter in Pisces, in April. I think it's April, conjunct in Pisces. It is a time to start looking at what systems we want to take us through the next decades. Because even though this isn't a World War III, it is of such a magnitude, along with COVID, along with climate change. We are at a critical point, and we've got feathers and restoration, imagination, some of what is happening, and why Zelensky has captured the imagination of us all is that he is imagining a better future. He has. Ukraine is imagining a better future for themselves. And we've got restoration. I hope that's for peace. Okay, let's get on to the tarot and some specific questions, and we'll go from there. Okay, so publicly, Putin is coming out and suggesting that there's a way toward peace. And, some would say he's wavering because he's not winning. He thought he would do this really quickly and nobody would stand up to him. Okay, so is he wavering? Is Putin the war criminal? Is Putin the war criminal wavering? Let's just give this a shuffle. Is Putin the war criminal wavering, and why? Because the cards will tell us why. Is Putin the war criminal wavering, and why? So I'm using the black and gold tarot, and I use the shamanic medicine oracle cards. So we've got the past here, the past, nostalgia for the past. We know he's written essays on it. We know that, and it's really just another way of saying, I want possession. The past, a cycle ending. The King of Pentacles, mirrored in the past, stuck in the past. The King of Pentacles and the past. Interestingly, sees himself as a czar now of Russia, but really he's just the head of the mob. And the ex-president, this was always my card for the ex-president of the US. So these energies are almost in the past, the end of that patriarchal energy, the end of telling people what they can do. Interestingly, Ukraine began its own Orthodox Church, It broke away from the Russian church because there was no separation of power between church and Putin. If you want to see why parts of America are ultra-conservative parts, the direction that they're heading, they took leaves out of Putin's playbook. But it's a patriarchal. You cannot take away someone else's freedom. It's a patriarchal. It's not. It's regressive. And in this, in 2022, you got, you know, we don't want to go backwards. We want to imagine a new future. The Ace of Swords depicts a new start through how, through the truth emerging. And so this is the underlying big theme of the times that we live in, the truth, we're seeing the truth. I'm so pleased to see the Three of Cups in the past. This talks about the unity of coming together. We can't accomplish anything without unity. And, you know, literally a wake-up call was needed to bring people together. Now, the Eight of Swords here, why is he wavering? Because he's facing restriction. The Eight of Swords is in the sky and crowning this reading. So he's looking for, he didn't expect the unity. Support for him and the war is in the past, if you want to look at it like that. The truth is emerging. And crowning this reading is the restriction. And he's worried about those restrictions, those sanctions. Really, there's no future for Putin except in a cell in The Hague. So this is what makes him so unpredictable. Let's keep going. He's struggling. He's struggling. He's not. He didn't win like he thought he would quickly. He's. This is also the end of a cycle here too. He will continue to struggle in the future as a result of the unity that of countries coming together. We have so much at stake. Why wouldn't we? Why wouldn't we? Our freedom is at stake. So the King of Cups in the here and now, interestingly, the energy moving from the King of Pentacles to the King of Cups. The King of Cups is that nurturing energy, nurturing, father-like, helpful, I will emotionally mature energy is replacing the King of Pentacles energy. So water energy, the emotions. This is also my card for Biden, interestingly enough. So we have the King of Cups being Biden and the King of Pentacles being the ex-president, but also the head of the mob, the head of the oligarch, Putin. So we have defending oneself. People are not seeing him as the King of Cups. They're seeing him as the King of Pentacles. Russia's still connected to the internet. There are still ways to see the oligarchs' yachts being frozen and the assets being frozen. And while everyday Russian people are, Russia's economy hasn't gone ahead. Their standard of living hasn't really budged in the last decade, which is why he was eyeing off Ukraine's resources. But we have defending oneself. This is at another level. Also, the US president standing his ground and not being pushed around in any way. I said in a reading yesterday on one of my other platforms on Patreon, I said that the way Biden has handled this will be seen historically as very important. So, Putin, back to Putin, hopes and fears. He's at the crossroads. I love it. He's operating with a blindfold. It suggests real mental worry, like he can't see his way forward for some, because of some blinker, blindfold. The moon is there as well. Now, we had the moon harmoniously placed, didn't we? What was that with Uranus? So he has to come to a decision soon. So he, in a way, as much as Ukraine's running out of time, so is Putin running out of time. Now we have here wish fulfillment. So he, in this wavering, he now wants something. What he wanted changed from February. Now he wants something else. What does he want? He wants the lifting of restrictions. Clarified by the devil. Never trust the devil. Never trust the devil. They'll tell you anything and sell you anything. Okay, so this is the smug merchant. He is copping pressure from the other oligarchs. Big pressure from the elite, the Russian elites. They throw that word around to describe the West, the Western elites. Let's throw it back. The Russian elites. He's copping big pressure at home. So he does, for all of these reasons, including a huge his anxiety here. As I said, there is no future for the war criminal except in a cell in The Hague. But his own people, his own elites are turning against him, and he knows it. Again, the Ides of March. So the Knight of Cups, so he comes forward with a bit of a peace offering. Page of Pentacles, the sanctions are biting. And we've got betrayal with the Three of Swords, the Ace of Wands, and the Five of Cups. So these energies are very mixed. There will still be a passage of time before the invasion of Ukraine is brought under control. Putin's brought under control. He's kind of saying what he thinks people need to hear. But he does have a huge decision based on things not going well for him, a huge decision to make, and he fears making that decision. Well, he should. He has blood on his hands. Okay, I want to see if they're going to implement a no-fly zone. Three out of four Americans, according to a poll, want to see that happen. The other side of the coin is that how would you manage that? Well, do you shoot down Russian jets? What happens? It might be simpler just to give Ukraine some jets. Okay, maybe that's what's going to happen. But anyway, will they implement a no-fly zone? Will the Allies implement? Funny, I'm using that word again, the Allies. Will the Allies implement? It's a World War II terminology. Will the Allies implement a no-fly zone? So we've got retreat, wounded in battle. And we've got the Knight of Cups, the peace offering. So I do feel that the ultimate solution to this is there will be a deal, as I said, that Ukraine will be able to take. Putin's getting more and more desperate by the day. There will be a deal that they will take. I still see peacekeeping forces come in, perhaps after that. The devil here, the devil. It's like, you don't you dance with the devil, there's consequences. The just in the past we've got so much people passing over, so much loss, so much blood in the soil of Ukraine. Now we've got the death card, the end here, the death card in the sky crowning this reading. I'm already feeling no, but we've got here in the immediate future a pact. So I think that something is going to occur. More assistance is going to be given to Ukraine. My feeling is that it might be done through an independent body, which would have to be the UN, wouldn't it? Okay, or some structure like the UN. I don't think it's NATO. That would be a red flag. It's something else here. There is an agreement reached between the Allies and Ukraine over something. The High Priestess, the unknowable, it's a bit, I get a bit, when she turns up, there's something coming that we can't foresee just yet. And we've got the Emperor in the environment around control. So I think that there will be something that will occur that controls Putin's threats They do something to control Putin's threats. Great deal in the hopes and fears of anxiety. What's the outcome card here? Yeah, they do something. There is something there. Something there. And the Justice card comes up, which tends to make me think of the, I did say the International Court would find him guilty of war crimes. I said that back in February. But there's something around a process here. Justice will be done. And there is an agreement here. So I feel that somebody has some kind of breakthrough, that there is an agreement with Ukraine to come in and help in some way. I asked, would there be a no-fly zone? I'm just not getting that it's that, even though these outcome cards would suggest that it is. The Justice card here would, I think it's through a process. Now we have giving and receiving help and the Magician. So we know the money and the Page of Cups. We know the money's getting to them. You know what it could be? It could be that supply that Ukraine pays for and is supplied with aerial capacity. That's what I think is happening at the moment. But there's a contract and a commitment coming up here. I just want to chase this down because I think it's important. It's a turning point in this whole invasion. What is this Ten of Cups? I mean, the Ten of Cups is families, it's legacies, the Justice card, justice. Ah, okay, the Emperor. Okay, so I think what Biden is going to do, and the Star, hope. There's going to be justice for families. So there could be peacekeepers brought in to control those corridors. It is for humanitarian purposes. It is to protect civilians. I think that's what's coming. Also feel that Ukraine will be given aerial help or aerial capacity. Not sure that it is a no-fly zone, though. Okay, there's a lot of the death card ending coming up here. All right, let's see. Will Ukraine be given jets, aerial capacity? Will Ukraine be given aerial capacity? Three cards jumped out. Then let's see what that is. So we have the Temperance card, the Ten of Swords, the ending, the complete downfall of somebody. You know who that card is for. It's for Putin. We have moderation and circles of support. I think there's a lot more support for Ukraine in various ways coming in the near future. I do feel there will be corridors patrolled or peacekeepers brought in, safe havens for civilians. I also feel there's some sort of deal around the supply of jets. Okay. All right. In the meantime, Putin is trying to save face in talking about the potential for a deal. One more question. I know, you know, you the video is long, but I want to see it's pretty obvious the GOP, some of the movers and shakers are moving on from Trump. This, again, war invasion has been a real wake-up call. The oligarchy movement in America is probably being seen for what it is. Okay, is the GOP moving away from Trump? Can we just have three cards? GOP moving away from Trump. If they don't, their midterm, Knight of Pentacles, slowly but surely. Is the GOP moving away from Trump? Slowly but surely. They want someone more reliable. Now we have the Nine of Pentacles, independence, money, the Ten of Swords, the end of the free ride here, I do feel for Trump. There's some kind of coming back together in a way. This is homeland security. It's also my card for the Democrats. So victory is in the past. And we've got abuse of power in the sky. Just as the GOP didn't hold Trump to account, they're going to turn on him. And we've got the walking away from something that no longer serves them. Yes, they're walking away. Page of Cups, something coming from left field. The Five of Pentacles. And we've got news here. News regarding his finances as well. I also want to say that I get the strong intuition the DOJ has a huge case against the ex-president. Huge case. Huge case. They've been studying it, studying the evidence, laying it out, mapping it out. It's like full-blown investigation of conspiracy and also fraud of the ex-president. I'm going to leave it there. Thanks for tuning in. Thank you for all your support for this reading. Also, I every video I do, I have to say, I don't do personal readings. There are scammers out there that are hitting all readers. If anyone approaches you for a reading, pretending to be me, report them, block them and report them. We can't fight this unless those scam accounts are taken down by the social media giants. It's time for a cleanup. It's time for a cleanup. So no, I don't offer personal readings. Please block and report anyone who is scamming you, pretending to be me. Thanks for tuning in. As always, namaste. Thanks for the support. Bye for now.